G'day folks, welcome back. A quick one today. We're at the launch, the Aussie launch of the 1200 Tiger. Obviously that's from Triumph. We've ridden this morning both the Rally Pro, and on this afternoon I'm on the GT Explorer, which is the big one with the big tank. 30 litres on the Explorer, 20 litres on the Pro, which is both GT and Rally. Rally being the off-road model with the 21-inch front, GT being the road model with the 18-inch front. It's an update. It's not a massive overhaul, but important updates. Four important updates really on what was already a terrific base. So we're talking a slightly revised seat shape. They've lifted the foot peg height for more clearance on the GT, both the Explorer and the Pro. The biggest difference that I found is actually the engine. So the bottom end of the engine, essentially a bigger, heavier crank in there. So they've worked on, you know, wanting more inertia in the engine off the bottom. And for me, I really noticed it, not so much at sort of the crack of the throttle, but more down low in terms of, they're just more accessible torque down low in terms of what I felt on the road. It's a bit easier for me to pop the wheelie up, which is always going to tick my boxes. I love this platform, the 1200 platform. Instantly felt at home, instantly felt recognizable for me. I've got probably more than 300,000 Ks on Tigers as a whole across 800s, 900s and 1200s, so it should feel familiar, and it does. I still think this is one of the best platforms for all-round adventure bike riding. The other change, they've got active preload adjustment now, so press a button, you can lower it up to, I think, about 20 mil. You've got to press a button, so it doesn't happen automatically. That's an interesting one. So it's probably more for the one-off when you're in a bit of an awkward position and you need that seat just a little bit lower and you want to get out of that. So yeah, I think they're good updates. So today, as I said, I was on the Rally Pro this morning, on the big girl, the GT Explorer with the big tank this afternoon. I'm going to do another video. I'm going to get the Rally Pro for an extended period of time. So we're going to cut it there for today, and I'll give you my in-depth thoughts on the Rally Pro when I get that for a bit more time and do some skids and stuff off-road with you. But very worthy updates. I think they've been really smart here. So it's not a revolutionary new update on what was really a new design only 2 years ago now. So Triumph for doing well. Again, I love this bike. I love the Tiger. The engine is just... it's just delicious. It's got such a good intake growl, and the exhaust note, even for a stocker, is really nice. But the thing that I like most about this platform is just how progressive the transition is from slide to grip. Like, it's just out doing drifts on gravel roads and stuff this morning on the Rally Pro, and it's just so easy to do nice drifts, and it doesn't hook up unexpectedly. It doesn't let go unexpectedly. Everything is just so creamy smooth and progressive. That's why I rate it. So, I'll see you in the next one. We'll talk more when we get the Rally Pro.